Please give a warm Minnesota Conservative Republican welcome to former State Representative Laura Broad.
Good afternoon, Republicans. I am proud to stand here today to nominate Pete Hegseth for U.S. Senate. He is a candidate with the breadth of experience, courage of conviction, and a tremendous ability of communication, a unique and winning combination. Pete is the candidate who can raise the money it will take and who can excite people to engage in the process on the grassroots level as well as the grass tops level. With Pete Hegseth as our candidate, the local and national interests in this race will magnify in a way that will allow us to beat Amy Klobuchar in November. Pete is the candidate who can build the organization, who will bring a conservative message to all the people in this state, who has already shown that he can and will raise what it will take to introduce the real Amy Klobuchar, the Washington, D.C. Amy Klobuchar, to the people of the state of Minnesota. Amy Klobuchar wants Minnesota to believe that she's a nice lady who works hard, so people should vote for her. Well, that's really the bulk of her campaign. Her slogan may as well be, "I may vote ultra-liberal while in D.C., but I want you to think I'm a moderate when I'm back in Minnesota. Oh, and by the way, I'm nice too." Well, that's not a slogan that should work, and it's not a slogan that does work. Amy Klobuchar focuses on the small issues while our country labors under the large debts and deficits that are killing freedom, killing jobs, and killing opportunity for our kids and grandkids. Now, do you really think that that's Minnesota nice? No. She wants Minnesota to believe that she's a moderate senator. But how moderate can you be when you vote with Barack Obama and Al Franken 99% of the time? Do you think that's moderate? We need someone who will stand up for us, someone who will fight for us, and someone who will lead, not follow. And Pete Hegseth is that candidate. We in this room recognize Amy Klobuchar for the Washington liberal that she is will not win the election. We need to endorse a candidate to run against her with a proven record that he can raise the money it will take to get that message out, to send the message and deliver the message to the people of this state. We need to endorse a candidate who is conservative on the issues, but who can communicate that conservatism in a way that wins the people of Minnesota over to our way of thinking. He's conservative, he's tested, he's a fighter. All great qualities we expect in our candidates. But along with all that, we need a candidate who can win, and Pete Hegseth is that candidate. I ask you to stand with Pete. Stand with me and stand with Pete to endorse as the endorsed Republican candidate for U.S. Senate. Please stand with Pete today. I nominate his endorsement.
I said they couldn't cut his hair until I got back from Afghanistan, and then we can't cut it. And now it's, well, once we get the endorsement, and then it's going to be the election, I did.
Approaches fatherhood like he does everything else, hands-on and 100%. When he was in Afghanistan, he bent over backwards to make sure that he kept his role as a father present, and that was incredibly important. Gunnar never forgot who his dad was, and he's young.
There's nothing better than watching your son be a father and be a husband and enjoy it and love it and wait to come home to it.
He's just devoted to his wife. He's devoted to his son. They have another one on the way, and it's just it's just a thrill for us as parents to watch them be parents.
I couldn't think more highly of my parents. We weren't wealthy. We're a middle-class family in a small town, Minnesota. But the advantage we got was in the values we had and in what my parents taught us about, you know, what it meant to be Americans, what it meant to be citizens, what it meant to be Christians, what it meant to be good neighbors. And so I didn't learn conservatism out of a book. I learned it lived out in front of me by my parents, by our family, by our church community, by everyone who sort of took the time to say, this is what's important in life and how you should live it out.
After 39 years in education and coaching, I still tell stories about the type of person that Pete Hegseth was and still is. Just last week, I told a player the story about Pete. And that's a lot of years.
Come on, get back. Ready?
What you got?
There it is.
Oh, yeah. Let's go easy.
Basketball's been a huge part of his life and the life of our family. Pete earned his way to get into Princeton, and so it was big. And yet, it didn't consume him. It didn't define him completely. He got there and he found other causes and other things to learn and fight for.
When I think of Pete and his military service in Iraq and Afghanistan, I am proud. I'm like any other mother. I wait by the phone. I wait for the letter. I wait for the text. And most of all, I pray.
Bus maybe five times, and it was, you just had this feeling like, wow, this is insane, this is a death trap. So this SUV just drove up next to it, rammed into the side of it and exploded and blew that bus up in the air and across the road and landed on a sidewalk. And the call was to send people up to assist the coalition forces that were hit. Captain Hegseth was one of the first people to secure the scene of the incident, and I don't think there would be any hesitation from Captain Hegseth to do his duty.
I'm an Iraq War veteran. I commanded an Army battalion fighting on the west side of Baghdad. I know what it takes to serve in tough conditions. I know what it takes to dedicate yourself to a cause completely. I know what it means to serve a cause greater than yourself. I see those qualities in Pete Hegseth.
Hey, he's got my respect for what he did as a soldier. He's got my respect for continuing to do it. Without Vets for Freedom, without what Pete Hegseth did,
I've walked the streets of Iraq since the insurgency.
Where would that mission have gone? What about the sacrifices of those who gave their lives over there for that mission?
Pete's no stranger to a tough challenge, whether it's in Iraq, Afghanistan, on Capitol Hill, or with the media. Pete is a consistent conservative. He's tough, he's tested, and he's ready.
Love for his wife and his son and his family is what brings him home.
You're so excited that he's home. I couldn't be more blessed to have Pete back. I know him. I know his passion. And there's nothing stopping him.
I feel compelled to be in this race, to hand something to Gunner that will be great, where he has every opportunity to grow up in small town Minnesota and go out and achieve big things. We can do this, but we can't take a break. We can't sit a year out. That is our duty. That's our responsibility, to hand over a special place that was given to us. That's why I do what I do. And I couldn't love them more. It makes getting up every day an easy thing to do.
We need to be the next generation that comes home and says, you know what, Washington did not serve us well, but we're prepared to go to Washington and serve America well.
You consistently consider like Pete to go to Washington, do the right thing.
What sets Pete apart for courage? Send him to Washington, I have no doubt.
Conservative of the Reagan School.
I want to serve the country of the United States.
The Hegseth of Vets for Freedom.
He's a Minnesota kid.
He's a decorated Iraq war vet.
Are you on the ballot in 2012?
Ladies and gentlemen,
please welcome our next United States Senator from the great state of Minnesota, Pete Hegseth.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, fellow delegates, it is with great humility and respect that I stand before you and ask for your endorsement to be our party's candidate for the United States Senate. I've traveled this state far and wide, and your energy and your passion is infectious. The reason you're involved is the same reason I'm running. We cannot afford to wait. It is now or never. Nothing less than the future of our country is at stake in 2012. America is the greatest country this world has ever known. But what we have is not inevitable and cannot be taken for granted. As Ronald Reagan said, freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction. It must be fought for and it must be protected. The question is, what type of America will my wife Samantha and I hand to Gunner? What type of America will we hand to our unborn child? Will you hand to your children and grandchildren? If President Obama and his reliable lieutenants, Amy Klobuchar and Al Franken, have their way, our children will inherit a declining nation, drowning in regulation, consumed by bureaucracy, and beholden to creditors. Now is the time to reverse that course, to fight for our conservative principles and bring back Reagan's Morning in America. Going along to get along won't cut it anymore. Now is the time for courage, now is the time for principle, and now is the time for leadership. As your candidate for the United States Senate, I will be the consistent, courageous conservative you deserve. Not because I say so, but because I always have been. Whether it was battling liberals at Princeton University or standing up to MoveOn.org and the ACLU on the national airwaves or leading men in combat, I have always stood up and I have always fought back. I'm not going to Washington to be popular. I want to go to Washington to lead, to tell it like it is. Our American values and our principles are too important to do anything less. Now, when I think back on where I learned these principles, these conservative Republican principles that we share, I certainly didn't learn them at Princeton or at Harvard or out of a textbook. I learned to be a conservative by watching the values lived out in front of me from my family, from my parents, from my community, and from my church. I learned to love my country in places like Wanamingo, Minnesota, sitting in the curb watching my grandfather, a World War II veteran, walk down Main Street on Memorial Day. I learned about family values and hard work around the supper table in Forest Lake, Minnesota, and in our home, watching my father and mother, a public school teacher and a homemaker, nurture their marriage and work to give us every single opportunity. I learned about faith in the church pews in White Bear Lake, listening to our pastor preach the greatest commandment, love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Finally, I learned courage in distant places called Baghdad, Samarra, and Kabul, where I watched our bravest fight and die for what we cherish, freedom. That's where I learned to be a conservative, and that's why I'm a Republican. That's why we're all Republicans. We believe in individual liberty, personal responsibility, limited government, lower taxes, traditional values, a strong national defense, and a reverence for our founding documents. All we need is the courage to fight for these principles. Because it hasn't just been Democrats who've gotten us into this mess. It's been Republicans who talk like conservatives on the trail, and then they go to Washington and they vote like Democrats. And we can't afford it anymore. But it will take more than courage to win this race in November. It will take the right candidate. We don't run against Democrats to make a point. We run against Democrats to win, and then to govern with our Republican principles. And while I've never run for office, I'm the only one on this stage today with the experience and the ability to beat Amy Klobuchar in November. We're going to build the organization. Because I've done these things with what I did with Vets for Freedom. When I took over Vets for Freedom in 2007, there were a couple thousand members, we had nothing in the checkbook, and I was handed the passwords to the website and told good luck. And in a year and a half, we built it to an organization of 95,000 members, 50 state chapters, and between 2007 and 2008, raised over $10 million to take on Senator Obama's liberal agenda. And then in 2010, we helped elect 8 conservative Republican veterans to Washington, one of which was Alan West down in Florida. Those are the type of men we need in Washington, and that's the type of man that I will be. You've seen what our campaign has accomplished in just 2 short months. And we will need more of the same to beat Amy Klobuchar, who has $5.5 million in the bank and the media in her pocket. Many Minnesotans have a warm fuzzy about her, but they have no idea how she votes. Do they know she's got a more liberal voting record than Keith Ellison? Not yet, but they will. Whether it's Obamacare, cap and trade, the failed stimulus, bailouts, or deficits, she's been a reliable rubber stamp for Obama ever since she got there. We also know that this election is going to be about jobs and the economy and our national debt. But you would not know that from watching Amy Klobuchar. In 2012, on the floor of the United States Senate, how many minutes do you think she spent talking about debt and deficit? Zero. How many minutes do you think she spent talking about jobs and the economy? Zero. The future of our country is on the brink, and Amy Klobuchar isn't even on the field. While she sits on the sidelines, our economy, our freedoms, and our country slip away. You know, I've served in some dangerous war zones, but I gotta confess, I'm a little nervous about this election. From what I've heard, there's an even more dangerous place to be right here in Minnesota. From what I'm told, you do not want to get caught standing between Amy Klobuchar and a photo op. You will get run over. But all jokes aside, this race is not about Amy Klobuchar, and it's not about Pete Hegseth. It's about our values, what we know to be true as conservative Republicans. We know that politicians do not create jobs. Small business owners create jobs. And it's the job of an elected official to get the heck out of the way so the job creators can do their job.
Absolutely.
You do that by cutting regulations, simplifying and lowering the tax code, and providing predictability. We know that our debt and deficit spending is literally crushing us and will drive us into bankruptcy. We are handing a maxed out $50,000 credit card to my son Gunner with no plan to pay for it, and your son. We need real spending cuts and entitlement reforms, and we need them now. We understand, as conservatives, the role of the federal government is limited and enumerated in the Constitution. Absolutely. Everything else is left to the states and the people. When we forget this, we get the kind of mandates and monstrosity that is Obamacare, and it must be repealed immediately. Finally, as a veteran of the tours in Guantanamo Bay, Iraq, and Afghanistan, I know the peace we have in this country comes through strength. America is an exceptional nation, but we have to fight for it. That also means we can never, ever cede an inch of our sovereignty to international organizations like the UN or the International Criminal Court. As long as I have breath, I can tell you my son and your son and the guys I served with will never be fighting in blue helmets under a UN flag. Never. We know what the other side wants to do. The question is, will we fight back? Will we do what is necessary to keep America great? Because as Reagan said, we're just one generation away from extinction. As Americans and as conservatives and as Republicans, we must stand and fight. We will not fiddle while Rome burns. We will not stand idly by. Stand up and fight for the principles that make this country great. Stand up and fight for our private sectors and what really brings jobs back. Stand up and fight for your children and grandchildren and the nation they're going to inherit. Stand up and fight with me. Take heart, have courage, don't bend, and don't apologize. America is the greatest country the world has ever known. Be proud of her. Join me in this fight. I'm asking for your vote. And together, I'm telling you, we're going to win this thing in November. God bless you, and God bless the United States of America.